Yo, B. They ready.
Do y'all? I just. Let's go. Listen to the words, guys. I want y'all to listen to the words. I want y'all to listen to the word. Wait, let me back that up because I was standing up or whatever. Hello, good evening, everybody. What's up? What's up, Cash? Shout out to the homie in J-Deal. What's up, Cash? Y'all know it's Wednesday night. We on IG Live, on our Brands and Beauty page, on Facebook, on this IG, on that IG. Ooh, honey, we got so many cameras, I don't even know what to do.
Okay, today we have 4 cameras going on, guys, so we're going to be looking summer everywhere. But, okay, this moment right in here, this moment is just beautiful, because if... Just, you know how some days you just feel yourself more than others? This is one of them days, okay? If you can't already tell. Listen to our girl B.
You gotta look everywhere. I don't even know what to do, okay? Y'all know it's 8 o'clock. We're about to get into it. But I would like to have everybody come in.
Hold on. Okay, so she said carry on. So go ahead, girl.
Good evening, y'all.
Y'all missed us last week.
And the week before.
But last week we did do Twitter because remember, last week was not our fault.
It wasn't.
Last week, Facebook and IG weren't working. So
that we wasn't went our to fault Twitter. Last week.
And we had a little dinner outing.
We had a blast on Twitter last week. Like, Twitter showed out over y'all IGsers and Facebooksers. We had our Twitter gang out.
I wish we could
go Twitter live tonight.
But we need another camera. Lord, we already on fold. Okay, maybe another time. It's already too much, okay? It's too much already.
Girl, all over the place, girl. But yeah, so good evening, you guys.
Yes.
Y'all know it's 8-ish. We are here. Tonight, we have a lot of topics to talk about. We are doing a lot of relationship topics. But before we get into the relationship topics, I am Miami.
And I am Shayla.
Well, I think Shayla says us first. Okay, start over.
Okay, fine. I'll say it.
We ain't do this in 2 weeks. Okay.
I'm Shayla.
And I'm Miami.
And we are Brains and Beauty times two. Okay?
Two.
So today's topics. Yes, we actually have a couple.
Today
is about relationships again, guys. Now, mind you, we're talking about relationships because y'all seem to like these topics.
Yeah, y'all like relationship topics. So, we're gonna keep giving it.
Now, again, y'all know we don't do the whole gossip thing. We like to take a story or something that's happening in the media and kind of make it more relatable to our own personal lives and to everybody's personal life, like what people actually go through day to day, not about the celebrity or whoever the story is actually about.
I do my hi, hello.
She is a mess.
Okay, so
we're gonna go ahead and start with the first topic.
Oh, before we get into the first topic, I want to just say shout out to this disgusting story. This is disgusting.
This girl.
There's only 2 billionaires, 100 billionaires. No, that's a female.
Billionaires.
Anyway, Bill Gates and Jeff Bezos are the only 2 people in the entire world who are worth $100 billion plus. And they're calling them a century billionaires. Y'all, as of today, there's only 2 billionaires, and Bill Gates just got added. He should have been there, but I don't know what happened, why he wasn't the first. But Jeff Bezos, who is over Amazon.
He's over Amazon, yes.
So it's only 2 of them, y'all. Like, how dope is that? So I just wanted to
It'll just, even you know, be even more even, dope when can, a black person is on it.
Yeah, and you know. Just but saying. We just wanted to give the kudos out to those people because they work very hard. They probably have sacrificed a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
They've done something right, right? So just wanted to just shout them out because we use Amazon a lot.
A lot, yeah.
That's a lot true. To Bill Gates and everything he does That's because true. They have contributed to the world. So I just wanted to, you know, recognize when do is do. It's just a disgusting story. $100 billion. All right, move on.
Oh, okay. And then we also, before we get into our first topic, we also want to make sure, guys, that we mention RIP to Soul Train. He was, if you ever attended FAMU, you should, if you don't know him, it's a problem. but he was a guy who used to be just a really, like a fixture at FAMU. That he used to be the guy that...
He was like the candy lady.
Yeah.
But he was more than the candy lady.
He really was.
Out of his trunk, he used to have all the good chips. And we used to always go... I know, I used to always go get a few things. What else he used to have?
I used to get a Capri Sun, honestly. And them oatmeal cream pies. That was like... He made sure he had them things on deck every time. He came through in the clutch every time. But he was also a really, really sweet guy. He gave a lot of great advice. He actually told a lot of great stories. He was on that campus for like...
A lot of years.
What, over 30 years. And he recently passed. So we want to just... Say rest in peace to Soul Train.
Thank you, True Child. Yes, rest in peace to Soul Train. 1 second moment of silence. Okay.
And we're going to move on. We're going to move on.
Okay. So, y'all, we have so many relationship topics tonight. Again, for those who are new, I am single. Shay is married. So, we're going to have a mix of topics tonight.
Yeah.
And I hope y'all are ready.
And again, if you're new, we also like to bring people into the conversation. Mm-hmm. So don't just think that we're just talking and we're not going to look include you in the thing. And again, if there's something that a topic we're talking about and you would actually like to go ahead and have yourself entered Be into back. The video,
yeah.
Then go ahead. 24 Belizean Queen. Hello, hello, beauty.
Hey, darling. Can you tell me if we're clear on your end? I just want to make sure I'm not fuzzy because now we have an extra.
We have an extra camera.
Yeah.
So we just want to make sure that it's not messing up the feed.
Yeah, we want to make sure it's not messing up. Please let us know if it's messing up, if it's fuzzy, if it's not clear. Is it delayed? Is it chopped up? Please let me know so I can just handle that right now. It's clear. Thank you, True Tyler 303. You know what? We here.
Silly.
So thank you for that. So we're going to go ahead and move on. To the first topic.
Yes.
Of relationships for tonight.
And the first topic is, you're going to go ahead and
The it. First topic is, if you are married, if you are in a relationship, meaning you are staying together.
Living together.
Yeah. Living together or married, do you guys have separate accounts and why? Ladies, so you have a separate secret account that he does not know about? Why?
Now, we're not trying to get y'all in trouble.
We just want to know.
If this is something, even if y'all are not, is this something that, if you're not in a relationship, and...
Would you have separate accounts? It's separate, though, yes. Because if you're married, that's one thing. But if you're just living together, yeah. Does that mean it's something different? Or do you take the same type of hit because y'all are staying together?
Yeah, so we're curious to know
what
you guys feel about that. Because we actually saw a couple of social media... comments about that. I forgot on what page it was on, but they were asking how, you know, like, do people have separate accounts? Do they think it's a good idea?
Separate.
You're in a relationship to have separate. Okay.
She's Just Brit said separate.
Okay.
I'm married, but our accounts are separate. Truly Tyler 303. She's Just Brit, because you're a female, I want to know, I don't know if you're married or just in a relationship and you guys are living together. Why? Is it a secret account? Or do you guys just keep things separate just to keep them separate?
Like, do you not just, is that a by choice? Or is that because, you know.
You got to hit it a gin, like, just in case
things don't work out.
Yeah. You know, because you guys maybe are not married, you're just living together, you're in a relationship. Do you have that secret stash as a backup?
So what I'm going to give my opinion on this one.
Okay.
Now, me and my husband have separate accounts.
Okay.
I was about to say secret accounts. Separate accounts. but we are actually currently... Ooh. Oh! Sorry, guys. My God. The iPad was about to hit the floor.
It gotta go.
Sorry. Okay, so we have separate accounts, but we are actually currently working on getting account together. I actually do think that it's good for, you know, married people to have an account that they share. I don't think there's anything wrong with having separate accounts.
Yeah.
As long as, see, it's the thing. When you see certain things happen to people, okay, people who were either formerly married or, like, for example, they were married and they no longer were, and then they say things like, I wish I would have had a separate account. I wish I would have saved for a rainy day, or I wish I would have been putting money aside so that if something were to ever happen and that person was no longer here for whatever reason, it could be for maybe they, you know, they unexpectedly passed, or, you know, maybe the relationship just didn't work out, or the person just up and left.
Yeah.
Because that has actually happened in my family before. The person just said they were going somewhere and up and left and never came back.
Cecilia, Marshall.
So, and I know, you know, that the person in my family who had to deal with that, I know she wished she would have saved for a rainy day, or she would have had a separate account. You understand what I'm saying? So I don't necessarily think separate accounts are bad.
Yeah.
I do think that if you're married, you should have an account together. And I don't really think that anything really should be a secret. Because I don't feel like there's any need. I'm sorry, Sydney. There's no any need to have a secret about it. Like, if I have a separate account, I have a separate account, and you know about it. Because I think that everybody, male and female, should save for. Y'all should have goals together, and you should have goals separately.
Yeah.
Just saying. That's in my opinion.
Okay, so secret account basically is, if you guys don't know, Shawnee O'Neal.
Yeah.
And how the rumors, again, we really don't even know what was true or not, but just the idea that she had a secret account with Shaq, and Shaq had the money, and she was stashing that money. Mm-hmm. And look what happened. They got a divorce, and that money came on point and in handy that he didn't know about. So when it comes to that type of stuff, would you have a secret account? I'm going to read some of the... We do have some stuff.
And Cecilia Marshall on Facebook. Hey, Cecilia. She says, no, I wouldn't have a separate account if I was married. Okay.
And if I was married, when I get married, I'm not going to have a secret account, I don't think. No, I won't have a secret account.
I think we would have separate or secret? Okay, there we go. This is different.
They're separate and secret are different. Secret meaning I am building some stuff, some wealth that he has no idea about.
Exactly.
Now, I don't know about that. Like, if I'm just in a... Well, I won't be in a relationship and living in the same house but if I'm not married. So I can't really talk about that. But if I was married, I would not...
That's weird. I'm sorry.
I would not have a secret account, but I would... be okay with separate accounts. We should have separate accounts anyway, from spending to saving, regardless of what. So let's go ahead and read some of these from IG on my side. Okay. True Tyler, it's a choice. He knows about the account, no secrets. Okay. Need Dedrick. I'm always not good, and I don't know if it's Dedrick or Diedrich. What mine is hers and what hers is mine. Dedicated to greatness. What's up? If it's separate, I feel that the person hiding something or don't really trust their partner. Okay. Play a Paul. Have a joint account. Then y'all have both have separate accounts, but don't make it a secret.
Yes.
I'm in a relationship, not living together, but we do and will have my own account. Yeah, my thing is, if I'm just dating you, I'm still having my account. Like, we're not married. Like,
yeah,
what's mine ain't yours yet.
Yeah.
Because if you want mine to be yours, we need to become one and get their responsibilities and all of the extras that come with that. If that's going to dictate your actions, then don't get married. I would have a partner. I would trust my partner, but in case you need to have your own. In case you need to have your own, Shay. You trust them, but in case you need to have your own.
I mean, I feel like I personally feel like that's only smart. Not say, but I don't think it should be a secret. Like, there's no reason to keep it a secret, because honestly, you know, again, in life, everything that you all do, yes, it affects you both.
Yeah.
But you all have goals together and you have goals separate. You have your own goals and things that you're trying to accomplish. It's not necessarily to say that it's for if y'all don't work out. Yeah. It could be simply for a rainy day because, again, nothing is guaranteed in this life. We don't know if, you know, I plan to be with you for 50 years, but is 50 years really going to happen? Will you pass in a year? Will something happen and maybe I get hurt or you get hurt and you're no longer able to work or whatever, and I have to kind of take the brunt of the responsibility now? So, again, it's not just about if we don't work out. You know what I'm saying? But I do. Okay. I don't think it should be a secret. Now, I think that it's a little different when the money is different. So you're talking about making someone who makes a lot of money compared to someone who doesn't so much. Yeah. And, you know, when you start entering lies into your marriage, it only goes down from there.
That opens up other doors. So exactly. I agree with, like, you guys, it shouldn't be any secrets. I don't know who else does the Shawnee O'Neal move. Yeah. But, you know, whatever works for you, but you got to be prepared for those consequences. But moving
and,
on,
go ahead. I'm going to read one more comment. Okay. And Beautiful Life Alexis, hey, she says, hey, I'm Alexis. Married and we have a joint and separate accounts. It works out perfect for both of us.
But there's no secret accounts though, Alexis.
Exactly.
Right. I doubt it.
Celia Marshall.
Again, every situation is different for that person.
Exactly.
Right, Cecilia.
Exactly.
But moving on to the next topic, we're going to stay on the topic of relationships in all aspects. Tonight, we have like 6 topics, so I hope you guys stay along with all of the topics. Give us your feedback. Do not leave. Talk with us. Communicate with us. And keep the conversations going.
Amen.
Next topic, fellas. We're going to start with the fellas first. Since y'all always say we always leave y'all. Fellas, what are the top 3 qualities that would make you settle down with a woman and say, you know what, forget all these birds and hoodlums.
So forget the flock.
Yeah, forget all the other sheeps out there. These are the top 3 qualities that will make me say, you know what, I got to go get this ring for her. These are the things that will make me settle down and get married to a woman.
And on top of this question, how long do you think that you should date somebody before you know that they're the one? How long do you think it takes? Because I know what my grandma used to tell me, and I would have to agree, but
what?
How long do you all think it takes before you should know whether you're willing to marry that person or not? Exactly.
Okay. The humble one, loyalty, great personality, and beautiful spirit.
Amen. I love that.
Okay. Them some good ones, because you want your future wife to be loyal to you. She has to have a great personality.
Yep.
If not, you'll just be talking to a dead wall, a dry wall, literally, with no paint on it.
Oh, not with no paint. Girl.
A drywall, new drywall with no paint or even sand it down. Okay. Anyway, and a beautiful spirit. I agree. I agree with that. I'm looking for some other things, but that's pretty good.
Yeah,
that's a good top 3. Shout out to the humble one. Fellas, what are the top 3 qualities that you must have from a woman that will make you want to settle down?
And ladies, same thing goes for you. Same question.
Yeah, and ladies, good job, True Tyler 303. She jumped in before we began to ask the ladies. I knew I wanted to marry my husband early on, but it took some time to learn the positives and negatives. Okay. She can stimulate me spiritually.
Now, who is this? This is
Dredic.
Sorry, we don't know how to pronounce that.
I know. Okay. Dredic. She can stimulate me spiritually, mentally, and has a head on her shoulders. No more than 3 to 5 years of commitment for him.
Ooh, 3 to 5.
3 to 5. That sounds like
that's a long jail time. 3 to 5. That really does sound like jail time.
That's your personal thing. The same thing about five to six years.
Ooh, okay.
Wow.
That's how long y'all think it takes to know whether someone is the one or not.
I think. Shout out to Andrea Fernandez who just joined. What's up, girl? We got to shout you out real quick. on Facebook. Florida 954. Personality, she has to be enjoyable and have a good heart.
Love that. That's very
some good
nice.
Ones.
Very
ladies. Good one. Cause we're gonna keep hearing.
Y'all
from
can
the
be
fellas.
Honest with these top three now. Yeah. Y'all don't have to sugarcoat it for us. You keep it real with these top three.
Yeah,
that's
and so
not
ladies,
really what it is.
What are the top three qualities that will make you want to agree to settle down with that man?
Beautiful life, Alexis. She said 3 to 5. That's a long time. I would have to agree. I think that's a long time. Like
to
my,
know if that's
yeah.
the person is the one. For me, I feel like I am open to a quick. Does it really take 5 years to know if that person is
no.
really the one? I think it should take less. For me, I think it should take less than a year for you to know if I'm really the one for you. Because I'm not trying to be here for 10 years. Because I'm not trying to be 70 years old waiting for you to realize if I'm the one for you. When I know, it doesn't take that long. Especially for women. We know if that man is really for us anyway within the next. Within a minute, you know, so I don't know.
I would say in 3 to 5, you already doing wifely duties.
We should have kids by then. We should have celebrated some what is called anniversaries and all of that. But
yeah.
Again, that's just our opinion. I know that's y'all opinion about the 3 to 5. It's just time I go.
Yeah, that's a long time. My grandma used to say, look, if a man doesn't know whether he wants to marry you within the year, he's not the one. He's
some,
playing one. He's playing
act.
Games, and he's gonna string you along until you make mm-hmm. it. You know, where it's not optional, it's not negotiable. It's, you know, it is what it is. We're not gonna play
yes.
house. Because after a year, most people are playing house, and that's just the truth.
Need I don't know. Dread. I'm gonna just say dread. Talking about yes, because you have to live with the person for 1 year, and she has to know how
live
to cook.
With no, ma'am. I don't think you living with you have to live with somebody.
Oh, we met young because that's why we're old. So we're
in a year,
2019. Mm-hmm. Depends on age. Young people should take their time. I agree. Depending on what the young is, 30s and above, you should know what you want already.
Exactly.
Working women, 2019.
Thank you. Yeah, you
ain't nobody got time.
Anybody got time for that?
You know, if you want to marry somebody, you know, because it gets to the end of the day, you guys. Grass ain't always green on every side of the doggone fence.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to know when you find somebody who have the top three qualities that we're asking you guys to give us and let us know what your top three qualities is to agree to be,
yeah.
you know, to be yeah. that person. When you have that, why are you trying to seek and
yeah.
play the field and go out there and think you got some green grass coming to find out it's turf. And now you want to come back to the real green grass that's flourishing with always flourish because of dirt and all of that is so prosperous. And
oh,
it's
wait.
Too late because now you're on a turf road. You can never come back to the green grass.
Oh, that went a little personal, but I'll just look. wait. Look. That was
so
a great analogy, though. Real talk. That was a great analogy.
So my thing is,
oh my God.
When you find them top three qualities, stop
playing. Amen. Yes. And I think that's the problem is that nowadays we just, a lot of people are playing. Like, you're taking advantage of the fact that you can have 3 to 5 years to figure something out.
Yeah.
And then now in 3 to 5 years, you don't waste somebody's time again.
Girl, wasting time.
Look,
wasting
in
time
a year,
energy.
You should know all of the valuable things that and qualities about that person, what you're willing to live with, what you can't.
Mm-hmm.
And at that point, you should be making some decisions. Like, who is here to play games? Who wants to do that? I don't want to sit here and play games.
It's 2019. It's too much Google out here. There's too many testimonies out here for us to hear and realize. Like, nobody ain't got time for that.
And honestly, guys,
no,
like,
baby.
Most, like,
Blue
you get, you,
babies.
You after it's a certain amount of time, you start to get comfortable. And you start to make a lot of things, a lot of your, morals and stuff,
okay,
they start to get real
y'all.
Lax. Okay, they start to get real lax. And we start to allow certain things to happen that we normally wouldn't allow to happen or we, you
mm-hmm.
know, certain qualities we want to say. Like, for example, if you're someone who's abstinent, after a year, you dating somebody and that, you know, y'all been in too many moments where it starts to get a little hot and heated, at some point, that ain't gonna last too long. Okay, so it's like, I don't understand. Like, you're always gonna find something.
Yeah.
That's in life. There's always gonna be
someone
or something out there that's tempting you.
Yeah.
Even once you get married, it's always gonna be something. You just have to say, look, this person has all of qualities that I want, and I in a mate, and I'm willing to build my life getting to figure out this person, because again, who my husband was 16 years ago when I met him, okay, is not who he is right now. I had to learn how to live and deal with all that and all the change, you know. But I was willing to. Yeah. And that's what it's about. You are willing to go through all of the rough times and all of the changes and all that kind of stuff because that person's supposed to be ride or die right here.
Yeah. You know, and again, saying? They got them qualities that just captures you exactly. Right there, so it make you ride to the end.
Yeah.
Andrea Fernandez, her top three was he was tall, humble, mm-hmm. and funny. And I agree that the tall, that's something I can get away with the talk, but the humble and funny is very important. You can't make a woman. No, that's well. I'm we could say our top threes
after,
before we move on. Yeah, and she said I married my husband 3 months after we met, and here we are 13 years later. And that's what I'm talking about, y'all.
Yeah.
Shout out to Andrea Fernandez because I'm the same way. Like my thing is, if we meet and we really hit it off and you really have my top qualities and I have your top qualities, like, why are we wasting more time? Like, let's get this thing popping. Let's get to this legacy, baby. Let's get these babies popping. Let's get this relationship. Let's break these generational curses. Let's start getting everything together.
Yeah.
And go. I don't care if it's 3 months, 6 months, 9 months. But if it takes you 5 years to realize I'm that woman God sent to you for from him, it ain't no way. I can't wait 5 years. I'm sorry. Honey, yeah. I'm an 80s baby. I can't wait 5 years.
Yeah, no.
It's mm-hmm. no way.
Yeah, no.
There's no way.
Yeah. I mean, again, this all, again, depends on
the person.
Not only the person, but the situation.
Yeah.
We're not talking about if you're 12. We're not talking about that. Y'all met each other at 12 and we talking about in the year y'all should be doing something. We talking about at 30. You should know what it is. You know what you want.
You know what you want. You have experienced enough terrible headaches enough to know what you really need in your life.
And when you're 20s, I give you 2 years.
Yeah.
I'd give you 2 years in your 20s because you're still
figuring out
some things, especially if you're someone who, like, you know, my parents didn't play that. There was no dating. You know, some people started dating when they was 11 or 12, and you kind of,
I didn't do that.
My parents ain't play that, so that wasn't going down.
Yeah,
so, you know what I'm saying? So, it maybe I give you more in your 20s to take a little longer, but
when you hit 30, that's it. Yeah, Crunch time.
Yeah, you
and
know
it's
what
sad
it is.
Because some people just aren't there mentally, especially some of these men. Mm-hmm. But we're not going in tonight. We're going to move on to the next topic. So y'all I would have met my husband at 28. I would only need a year to know. Before we move, let me see if anything else was out.
Okay,
there.
Wait. I'm gonna read some. Beautiful Life Alexis says her top three qualities are a good provider, a lover, and someone I can block out the world with and be lost in love.
Oh, I love that, girl.
Don't write a novel. Okay, don't write a novel over here.
That sounds
just
like
to get into it, okay?
Ooh.
Those are good ones, though.
That's good.
But the first one, surprisingly, the first one who said her top three was a good lover. That's why I said I want y'all to be honest. Like, because some people that really is there. If that's not good, they're not interested.
Wait, lover meaning lover as lover entirely or lover meaning lover? I want to know what we're talking about. Because I don't know if loving is a top because we can always grow and we can always learn. We can always get that together. You don't have to be Bill Gates in that area for me when it comes to loving. We can learn that, baby. That's that take time. We got all our whole life to take time to get that together.
See, You are the first person that I've ever heard say that.
It's true.
Ever.
But okay, this is my scenario why I say sex is not that important when it comes to being perfect in the bedroom. It takes people years and years and years and years to get what? The resume.
She said both. She answered her question.
Okay, both.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it takes people years. The people who are great lovers, right? Mm-hmm. Like sexual lovers. It took them time to get there, right? Yes or no?
I'm sorry.
It took them time to get there. Great lovers.
Yes.
It took them a lot of experience to get there. Yes or no?
Unfortunately, it took them too much experience to get there.
So if it takes experience to become a great lover, that means if you find that person that is meant for you,
and you're
baby,
willing to work with them,
we have all our life, baby, to get it done, baby. Which means we're gonna have experience with each other.
Yeah.
We're gonna
what's
get
good
there.
For one woman may not be the bomb for
and I'll be coming to my bedroom with these little tricks and dip that you done worked on Sally Lou and Sue. I don't even like that. So my thing is, that's why I say sex really isn't important to come to the table with, because we can always learn it, just like you learned before. That's mine.
Okay, we got another one dedicated to greatness. Hey,
I'm just saying
his top three is a woman who can pray.
Okay.
A woman who's loyal and a woman who has a lot of charisma. Good top three. Really good top threes.
That's good.
I like that.
What's your top three, Shay, before we move on to the next topic?
Okay. I would say my top three is, I don't really have a three. I kind of have like a 7, 8. But okay.
Now,
fine.
I know I don't have three. You know I have a couple.
I would say a top three. God-fearing man, a man who is in love with the Lord, okay, who wants to raise his family under, you know, the guidance of the Lord. That's number one. Yeah. Number two.
Hey, good people.
A man who's loyal.
Oh, yes, Jesus.
A man who is loyal.
Can you be loyal, though?
And a man who will do any and everything for his family.
I like that.
Now, I'm not talking about no illegal anything, but who will work his behind off to make sure that his family knows that they are not only loved, but he will do anything to make sure that they have whatever they need to have to get through.
Oh, God, look at all these other
okay.
ones.
But we're going to go through.
Facebook,
Facebook is just, it's people responding. We ain't even seeing
it.
I'm sorry.
Oh, my God, I'm so sorry. East joined in. What's up,
hey,
East?
Hey, Bonnie.
Bonnie said top three qualities is tall, funny, financially secure.
Okay.
All right, girl. Getting my fiance for 5 years before engagement. Okay, that's a different. You know.
But see, hers was long distance. Now that's a little different because you're not on a regular schedule with that person. Where you're around them all the time, so it takes a little longer to know somebody when you're long distance. So that's a little different. Who else says something?
That was basically it. So everybody who's tuning in, we're talking about relationships tonight.
Yeah,
all the way to the end of our hour, we're gonna have different little topics. We have like four more topics left to talk about, but right now we are on what are your top three qualities from a person that will make you want to settle down with them. And that comes from, we want to hear from
Dread. We said we're going to call him Dread, right?
That's considered tall.
What's considered tall to you?
Tall is just taller than me.
Okay, taller than you.
And I'm 5'7". So if you're 5'7", 8, 9, 10, 6, 3.
So you wouldn't date a short guy?
Like a 5'4"? I don't know. Because now when I put on my heels,
you're a giant.
I'm 6 foot over you.
So it
all depends. Now, if he has everything else that I need from a man and he is a little short, I can, he got everything. I can work with that.
Okay.
Long as he's not insecure with his shortness and he accepts that, like, honey,
I know I'm still the bomb.
But, you know,
yeah.
Like, he just, you know, I can do it.
He's still securing his
manhood. I prefer somebody at least my height or taller? Of course.
Bonnie, I already knew your answer, girl. If it was a 6'3" or better, I ain't messing with it if it's short, okay?
Let me see the top three qualities. Let me see. Of course, he has to be just not a man of God. He has to have some fruit on that tree that shows it. I'm sorry. He has to have some fruit. He has to show some fruit. Now, all the fruit don't have to, the whole tree don't have to be full of fruit, because I don't have a tree full of fruit. That's supposed to be the world way of saying, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But he has to have some fruit. You know, he has to be okay with the things that I'm okay with, which is waiting to marriage and like all these things, and want to be married and want to be a faithful husband.
Faithful, keyword.
Faithful. spit everywhere, Faithful. And Faithful meaning not just me only as his woman, as his apple of his eye, as the wife, as his as his mother, his kid. I mean faithful in the entire relationship, meaning our goals. He's faithful to the goals that we set for ourselves. He's faithful with, of course, not nobody else, loyal. You know,
you got a question.
Faithful in all areas in life of what we have as a whatever. And the third one, I honestly just think, only three?
Okay, so that's the hard part. You only pick three.
Okay, so he agrees with the lifestyle. We are equally yoked in all of that area that includes like six things. And then this one is faithful and it includes like six things. Okay, so this one, he has to have a great personality. He has to make me laugh.
Yeah, for you, yeah.
He has to have
For you, everybody can
sense
not
of
be,
humor.
Everybody can
he has to
be
okay with being adventurous. Yeah. He has to be okay with just living life and just laughing at himself.
Yeah.
Because if I laugh at you, you gotta be like, oh my God, girl, you right. All right, whatever. And he has to have a sense of humor.
Yeah.
I want to laugh because I'm going to make him laugh. I'm going to make him live and laugh, honey. So, I that's my top. So,
Aisha says,
genuine.
Oh, girl. A man's man. Ooh, I love that. And a jack of all trades, master of himself. You know what, girl? Those thoughts.
Isha, that is so good.
That's a good one, girl. You did that.
Okay, wait. Up, so
we have a comment. We have a question.
Okay,
actually.
And we gotta go on to the next one. But
okay, we're gonna answer this one question. So Dress Her asks, I'm waiting until marriage. Not secure if he would cheat until then. I don't know. Do you think it's a waste of time if I'm celibate and he's not?
It is. Let me tell y'all something right now. I'm going to just drink a little bit of water. I'm drinking water, not soda, people. This is water in a can that's sparkling. That's going to make me burp. But let me.
I'm going to let her answer this one.
Dress Her. So you think it's a waste of time if you're celibate and he's not? Girl, it is not a waste of time. What's a waste of time to be with a man who sit here and says he wants to be celibate with you and he know he don't want to be? That's a waste of time. Because at the end of the day, if that's not his true intentions to really be equally yoked with you mentally on that level and beyond what it really means to be celibate. Like if he doesn't mentally connect on what it really means to be celibate and wait till marriage, you don't need to be with him. I'm telling you, because it's not going to work.
And
there before, and you're going to see the signs, and please don't ignore those signs. Please don't ignore the signs. Because a male who really, truly, really, truly knows that when he becomes your husband, he's supposed to be that leader. If he can't lead y'all right now to celibacy,
don't think
he's not
going to
be able to lead you nowhere else.
Yeah.
So don't ever think you protecting your self-worth is a waste of time. Don't ever think that you lowering your standards or keeping your standards high enough to where he needs to match that is never a waste of time.
Amen.
Because you are worth it. You are well worth the wait. And if he does not agree or even think that that's something to do, let him go right now. Because if you don't let him go right now, he's going to play with your time.
Mm-hmm. You wasting time.
He's going to play with your feelings. He's going to play with your heart. Mm-hmm. And you are not to be played with or mistreated or misused because you are a woman of God. You are a daughter of the Most High. And that's why you're waiting and you're choosing to wait for that. So don't ever think that's a waste of time because your worth is worth it.
Amen.
And if he don't agree, let him go. Tell him deuces, baby.
Kate rocks.
Go find a bird to go play with and feed her some crumbs. Because this one right here, honey, she don't get crumbs.
She waiting on the Most High to get to bring her what she needs.
And I'm gonna leave it at that.
Because
it's never a waste of time while you're waiting. And all my people out there, men and women, if you want to wait to marriage, let the others go. That's how you weed out the idiots anyway.
Yeah.
Let them go because that's not for you.
Yeah.
This is a real life commitment. And if those people do not understand the reasons why you're waiting, y'all not equally yoked from the start. And if he can't wait for you right now in a single relationship of y'all dating, you think he can wait for you in your marriage? Because he don't even have a mindset of why he's waiting. He has no self-control.
With I think body, that's the biggest thing. You don't have no self-control.
He has no self-control with his body. He has no self-control with his mind. He has no self-control to be able to lead you and your family and your kids to anything because he can't even control his little penis that is controlling his whole entire existence. So
he's gonna turn away
from that. I'm gonna move on to the next topic because I could do this all night and I'm not. And I hope that she helps said, you, girl. If you ever have any whatever, reach out to me, honey. I will let you know. Girl, keep your worth up. Forget these little dirty behind penis guys. They dirty. Cheers. Move on. Okay, next question.
Yeah.
But it's the truth because sometimes it's not enough for us talking about our celibacy. And it's not enough, not even celibacy, because celibacy sometimes ends with certain people.
Yeah.
It's not enough of us talking about waiting to marriage because yeah. that's deep, man. Like, you have to find somebody who at least equally yoked there. And sometimes when y'all equally yoked there, it still don't work because other things still have to fall in line.
Yeah.
But let me tell you something, too. If you have a man that comes and say he loves God and he's willing to wait, that doesn't mean he's your husband.
Yeah, yeah. Don't believe that. Don't believe
you
what
have,
he says.
You have to
junk.
Still be capable and not capable, compatible in other areas as well.
And observe those actions.
Please.
Words.
The red flags come up all the time. Oh, girl. And you can't be the only one stopping the heated moments. He has to have some self-control.
To be able to stop.
Again,
yeah.
Because you guys are human. You're going to be in those situations where you're kissing or something like that. Or a touch of an arm and that just heat y'all up. You know what I'm saying? You can't be the only one stopping it. He has to have some type of self-control, some type of love for you in a decision that you want to make.
And respect for
and you. Respect for you and for himself.
To be like, babe, you know, we say
we doing too
go
much.
Here. Yeah.
Our goal, he can't keep up the goal with y'all right now to marriage. How is he going to keep up goals, honey, in a marriage? Yeah, I'm going to move on. So, I could do that for a whole hour.
All right. What's the next topic?
Next topic. Would you date or marry somebody who makes less money than you?
Okay. Now, we actually talked about this last week
on Twitter.
But we wanted to bring it up again. Because for some strange reason.
I'm with you, girl.
So many people.
I'm going to take that note.
Asks her all the time. They seem to think that she would only would date somebody who makes a lot of money. And I don't know if it's because in today's society and on social media, you just see any girl who looks halfway decent is always next to a baller or always next to somebody who got some money or seems to have a lavish lifestyle. So that's what's just assumed. I don't know. But I am very curious to kind of know why people think that about you.
About
me? Because you don't... Nothing about her, if you ever heard her speak, if you ever have heard anything, but nothing about her says, I'm not talking to you, I'm not dealing with you unless you make this amount of money. Nothing about her says that.
But you will have to get to know me to know that. And I think some people are just afraid to get to know me or something. Like, I have no idea. But I don't know.
I just think that's so weird.
It's weird for people to assume that I would only date a guy for his money. Like, that's weird. That's not fair to me. But at the same time, I cannot worry about what people think about me.
Yeah.
My thing is, you have to understand, I know it's a cliche thing to say, like, a book. What is it? The book cover and the book.
You can't judge a book.
You can't judge a book. And the thing is, like, what is the cover then? Like, what's the cover I'm displaying?
I think it's just if you're a pretty girl, it's, I don't know, you know, and everyone's coming at you, then you have your pick of the litter, I'm assuming.
I don't
so
know.
They just assume. I don't know. It doesn't make no sense to me. But whatever. But,
but anyway,
to answer the question,
would you I did not marry somebody less than
I did not marry for money.
Yeah. And I would not marry for money. Because I feel like even though I would. You know, want to date a Jeff Bezos. But as you can see, he getting divorced right now. She about to take,
yeah,
half,
she about
of
to take half of that.
Shout
time,
out to Jeff Mrs. Bezos, honey.
It's just about to be Bill Gates on that list by himself.
Oh, yeah. He going to be by himself. That's true. So, she said,
how much less?
Okay, so my thing when it comes to dating somebody less, my thing is you still have to have a mindset of a provider, right?
Yeah.
You still have to know you have to work and you're not going to be at home doing nothing.
Yeah.
You're not going to be playing video games all day. all day, 24/7.
Yeah, no.
And no job, and expect me to pick up the pieces while you're, I don't know what you're
or
doing.
Or you even expect for me to work and take care of kids and take care of you.
And clean.
No,
and,
sir.
And wash clothes. And no, matter of fact, we should be splitting that anyway.
You
should
be working harder than me because I got 3 jobs.
So my thing is he doesn't have to, what's less, like she say, what's less.
How
my thing
is
dating somebody or marrying somebody for money, for me, I'm not doing it. I don't care how much money you have. If you have a rotten personality, a rotten soul, a rotten spirit, and you have millions and trillions of dollars, I will not, because you're not even worth. If it's about the money, that means I will go find somebody else who have more money than you then. If it's about if it's about the money,
yeah.
That means somebody will always have more than you.
Yeah.
And which means when you get down to this number, I'm going to leave you because you're thinking it's all about money. And I personally can't date or marry anybody just for money. Now you
because
have to
your
provide.
Decisions don't stop there.
Yeah.
Your decisions about money don't stop there.
Yeah.
So you got to think about what else they would think is as important that agreed. Probably won't align with things that are just as important, you know, for you. So I did not marry for money. I feel like if someone has a passion, you can see that passion in them. Mm. You can see that they're hard workers
pour
or whatever.
Them. Help
then
them.
Help them to come up. Help them to, or y'all grow together. I don't have a problem with that. That's just my personal opinion. Now, again, in the household that I grew up in, it was very much, you should be thinking about those things. And it was much more, it's funny because we actually had this conversation with Angie before about how white girls are kind of raised to
go after.
You think about, no, you, when you're dating someone, you should be thinking about where you're going to be in the next 10 years. And if you want to be a certain place, then you need to date and marry a certain kind of, you need to date the man who's going to be where you want to be. You don't need to date his potential.
Oh yeah, I'm not dating
unless there's something, some kind of fruit there that's already being shown that says, you know what? He is going to be, you know, that's what they're taught. We're looking at the man got nice shoes and all this foolery.
Oh,
he got to drive a nice car.
And he's telling me, I don't care.
Girl,
what
he landed, you know, nice and all that kind of stuff. Girl, please. Okay. I think our mindset really should be more like they are. And I'm wondering why we don't do that more. I mean, not come off as being gold diggers. Now I'm not saying that at all.
No.
But
you just want a man to provide. That's all.
Yeah.
You want him to provide no matter how much that dollar amount is. But Bonnie said, I think if you're a successful woman, you work very hard, you're doing yourself a disservice if you don't seek a man
who's just as ambitious.
Bonnie, I agree with you. But ambitious, what about he's very ambitious, but it doesn't equally match in monetary?
Yeah, yeah.
Right? And Isha said, I would date a man. This is fake. However, most men can't handle it.
Their
egos go crazy. I feel like money doesn't matter because we're going to win with the right mindset. Yeah. Again, if we're on the same goals, if you come in and you're not making a lot of money and you're making less or whatever case, or we're equally with the money part, or who knows, you may be making a little bit more than me or a little bit less than me. If we have a goal in mind to get more money,
yeah,
we're going to go get that more money. So if you're not making that money right now, but you have a goal that can actually bring us more income in, I'm ready. Let's get it done.
Yeah.
Let's get this secondary income or this third income or this fourth income. Let's go get this money together now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because maybe you needed me to come in. Maybe. Not saying you do. Maybe you needed me to come in and help you and get to that.
To be another reason
or
why you push
versa.
Harder.
Yeah, or vice versa. You can come in and help me get to the next level. Get me on point so that we can make money together as a team, as a one, as a husband and wife. Baby, that's what it's supposed to be about.
But we love both of those comments, Isha and Bonnie. Very good. Very, very good comments.
Oh, hello one right here before we got to go. Oh, let me see. My.
Okay, we're about to read some comments from Angie's IG.
True Tyler, some men are intimidated by how pretty you are and shows more about them.
Okay, more about them. I agree with that.
What do you mean it shows more about them? Like what?
It shows where their mindset is.
Okay.
How they think, how their mind works.
Okay. That it's not deeper.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, I'm not deeper. Like, I'm just surface. Right?
Well, that's what they think, which is their mindset. Which okay. is like, why would you think that? And you've never heard her speak, or you've never heard her have a conversation. Why would your immediate thing be, she's this just because she's pretty? That's insane.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's not fair. It's like, dang, what am I giving off? But anyway, next comment. I mean, next topic. We're almost to the end. You guys,
yes, guys,
you guys,
we have, like,
keeping up. Tonight is all about relationships. A certain age ambition has to translate into dollar signs.
I love you, girl.
This is true.
I love you so much.
Bonnie said on Facebook.
I love the intelligence in that comment. It's
at a certain age, ambition has to translate into dollar signs.
I love her so much, Lord.
I agree.
At a certain age, I agree. You, there should be some fruit from that tree at some point. Yeah.
Soul ties.
Oh, Lord. Soul ties. That's going to be the last topic of the night, child. Soul ties.
You think it's going to be the last one?
Yep. Look. Okay, we're on topic number four.
Soul ties.
Yes.
What is the importance of letting them go when entering new relationships? How important is it to let go soul ties before you move into new relationships? Soul ties. What is it that you have done or did, people everywhere? What is it that you can give advice that we can read out to somebody else that you've done and it worked to let go of your soul ties? Because we all know you cannot go into new relationships with soul ties because they're going to always be there tied solely to you.
Yeah.
So you have to let those go. So with me, I just feel like that's very important. Like, you should be able to cut off anybody who would threaten the new relationship and the goal of that next relationship that you're entering or want to be a part of or want to pour their love into and have set new goals. So if that other person is going to be a threat, they got to go. They got to be cut. Because now I'm trying to go to a new wave in my life and you're now, I got to cut you off. You got to go. So with me, before I want y'all to go ahead and give y'all comments, what have you done in your past to let go soul ties and how important those are? With me, when I move into a new relationship, all the exes, they was already gone anyway. They're definitely not infiltrating my new bae in me and my relationship. They can't even have an ounce or inkling or
y'all,
peak
when she's done with y'all.
Or a piece of lint into my new relationship.
When this one is
especially
done.
Especially who finna be my husband next. You think anybody finna baby. And I know he's gonna feel the same way. Soul ties have to be cut because that can really mess up not only your relationship, it could mess up your future. It could just mess up everything. You could just be playing with destiny and all of that. Like,
and it keeps you emotionally attached to that person.
Yeah,
if
just,
you don't break
it's just
it.
It's a waste of time. Like,
so us young ladies, and there's a couple that I know who just, you hold on so long and you're not willing to let that person truly leave
go.
Your life. Like, go. Like, there's no conversations. Constant talking. There's no, like, they're keeping that fix. They have a fix on you. You have the fix on them. And you cannot let it go if you don't cut that tie. So this one right here is just a look. If there's ever somebody who has known how to cut a tie, okay? She plays no games, okay?
Why? And there's
no
game.
There's a reason why.
Very
it's not
important.
It's not to be extremely mean or whatever.
No.
She's
and
trying
it's not to
be
bitter.
Herself.
It's not about bitterness. It's about none of that. It's about we did not work. Hello, you have to go. Hello, the next person in my life, I'm really vibing this person. And baby, you're not that powerful for me to mess up my next relationship because we didn't work. So why am I stringing you along like you're a piece of crack or something?
Or stringing you along, period.
Why?
That's what it is, emotionally.
Like, do I really need you in my life that bad?
Yeah.
Like, now you're trying to become a god in my life, and there's only one boo. There's only one I'm committed to for the rest of my life, no matter who comes or goes. And now you trying to be my second God? As if I can't live or breathe without you? No, that's not what we do, baby.
And on top of it, whatever you did to get dismissed.
Honey, that okay. means
you really messed up. Okay, you messed that up. And maybe you'll learn for the next person you're in, relationship you're in, that, you know, you'll do better. It prepares you for the next relationship, but we have to learn how to cut.
You got
it will save us so much. Oh my God. Save us so much time and disappointment.
Time, disappointment, heartache, confusion, time, and time.
Time and
we
time.
All not promised a lot of time on this earth, man. Like, period. Like, you don't know. And my thing is, if it don't work, it don't work. And if it don't fit, it don't fit. And it got to go. Like OJ said, if the glove don't fit, it can't.
Hold on. I can't with you. Let me read Bonnie's comment. I need y'all to hear Bonnie, okay? Bonnie says, in the beginning of my relationship with my fiance, I blocked all my old hoes. This is a girl talking.
Listen,
I cut all my hoes off on social media so I can focus on only him. You can't be trying to move forward and renew yourself and get into a certain headspace if you still entertaining foolery from the past.
That don't work. That didn't work. That's a hot terrible mess.
It ain't changed. It ain't
that
different.
Ain't gonna change.
Yeah.
That's stringing you along, which wasting your time, because now either we're gonna go or not. Ain't nobody got, like, we're too, like, again, this is 2019. Ain't nobody got time for not knowing what can happen in life as situationships. We all have seen it in the news, in the media. What happens with that? Yeah. What is the point? Like, what do you get from that besides looking like a crackhead? And I ain't nobody's crackhead. So the old gotta go and stay in the past, in the dumpster where they belong. And that's it. And shout out to the next, well, you know, the dumpster of life. Like, you're not dumpster.
That's rough. Which means
it has to go. Everything in the dumpster goes in the trash. You never see it again. Which means when you go in the dumpster, you get taken away and you're never seen again.
Sorry, friend. I always love your analogies. It's okay. Okay.
Well, but anyway, we have 4 minutos left for our live. I want to thank everybody for joining in tonight.
Yes.
We want to thank everybody for joining
us. Y'all were very, y'all comments were hilarious. Thank you to
save this live. I will.
We're definitely going to save this live and repost it to anybody that you know who does not follow us. If you are not following us, make sure that you hit that notification bell. Make sure you hit follow. Make sure you go on YouTube and subscribe and follow our channel. Make sure you go on IG and follow not only Brains and Beauty Times 2, but Shayla Maisha and Miami. Ooh. Make sure y'all follow us, because we're definitely going to start upping a lot of our content. It will not just be shows, but we're definitely live shows. Some of it will be actual recordings, beauty recordings, reviews. Y'all know we love South Florida, so it'll start being like reviews around the city of different places that we went, so when people come and visit, they know where to go.
Care of my newborn. Aww, congrats on the newborn.
Yes, boo, Bonnie. I cannot wait to meet him. Love you. But like, we just thank y'all so much for joining. It was great, great conversation.
We have
tonight.
So many more topics to go over. We'll have to roll them over to next week.
Yeah.
With a combination of infidelities.
Yeah, I think that's what we're gonna focus on, infidelity topics.
Topics around that, and along with more relationship topics that we could not finish tonight, because y'all know how we get when we get on one topic, honey, and get a little heated, honey, and we have to keep going, honey.
I can't with her. Well, okay. So if there's anything that you all want us to start talking about, any future topics, please put them in the comments below. Please don't think that because we didn't read your comments today or we didn't see them that we don't read them, because we definitely do. And we actually consider them for future topics if they're really good.
Yeah.
So
we do go back and look. It's just that we can't go to everybody's comments.
Yeah.
But trust me, we really appreciate everybody's comments. Like,
yes.
For real. We love y'all feedback. We love the hearts. We love y'all coming in, saying, hey, whatever. You know, we just love y'all.
We really
would not be here if we didn't love y'all. But we love us too. But we wouldn't be here if we didn't love y'all. Yeah, great contact. Need 2 or more shows a week. Oh, that's a lot of shows.
Yeah.
Make sure we do every Wednesday. But I like that. Great
every
content.
Wednesday, and maybe
2 or more. Something else different.
Something different thrown in during the week. We're definitely going to try to work it.
But
thank you for the compliment.
2 girls with 2 schedules in 2 different worlds trying to come together as one. And right now we can only offer at the very moment a live on Wednesdays at 8-ish.
But we're definitely going to try to add more different kinds of content for men and women, not just
We love our fellas.
Yes, we do.
And we love our ladies. single or married. We always respectful for all the married people out there as well. Yes. So, you know,
so make sure y'all,
honey, we are brains and beauty.
Tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend. Yeah. We say this every week. Make sure you do that. Make sure y'all share our content if you can, all that kind of stuff. But good night.
30 seconds left on IG. Facebook, y'all get an extra minuto with those just because y'all Facebook.
Hey, Tiff.
And IG, you on countdown?
Mine's a little longer. But yeah, but we thank y'all again tonight. And if y'all have any,
thank y'all for staying.
Yes. If y'all have any comments and stuff, make sure y'all put it in the things below. Love y'all.
Always said pause due to poor connection.
All right, well, Angie's just
my live is over. Shade.
Mine has
countdown.
40 more seconds. But again, thank y'all for joining.
You're welcome. Dress her anytime, boo.
Oh, you know what we should go to? Okay. So Isha, Bonnie, Indred, we don't remember how to pronounce her name. So sorry, because I couldn't really read it. Dress her, that CGJB, dedicated to greatness. Those are just a couple that I can remember. that commented. Tiff, hey boo. But we really, really appreciate everybody for joining, and we pray all that y'all continue to do so and support us and support your black businesses. Let's not forget to do that.
Yes.
Poor connection over here. You know what?
I don't know. They just don't want
us to be great. Oh, I don't understand.
Chris. Yeah.
But anyway.
Ooh, Facebook, y'all got us all to y'all still.
Y'all do. It's just us.
IG is gone. They gone. They is on the World Wide Web.
So next week, topics are about infidelity.
Yes. Are you ready?
Yes. And we want to hear some real life stories. We're going to share some
stuff. We may share some a little stuff that we've experienced.
Oh, God. We don't get too personal, you know.
But just enough.
Just enough to give y'all some. You know, it's not everybody goes through it. Well, most people go through it at some point in their life. Mm-hmm. And you can go through really the shock face, really, Tiff. I know that's gotta be you. But yeah, so we love y'all.
And we mean it.
And we mean it.
Toodles. See y'all next Wednesday
at 8 p.m. Okay. 8. Black people CPT time. Bye y'all.